Howdy, YouTube neighbors. JC Locke back with Covenant 1 Adventures. We are going to be taking a look on this final Friday of April at the... Is it Friday today? Yeah, it is Friday today. Final Friday of April at the Equestrian Exile Champion Tantibus and Night Terrors, the starter card that costs 2 but can potentially gain a... Ember on Slay. That's quite fascinating. So we ran through the standard champions back up the first time. So with this one, we're going to do a series with we got the Exile champion, so we'll have Exile backup. And hopefully I can get this figured out. Alright. It's Poison Joke again, the thing I never figured out what to do with. And packed audience, we've worked with that before. It's okay. Molting Imp, not my favorite imp, but it's fine. Dazed Talos, we got... What is this? Looks like Vanilla Arcus, and we have Seraph the Patient. So, bosses we will need to have plans for. And I would like to take a look at my champion before I take a look at an artifact. Alright. Wow. Okay, this is interesting. So, as an action, remove all sap from friendly units. Okay, so that combos with the poison joke here. So that's potentially worth considering if we have... Yeah, if we can get Endless Void or something like that, that's very interesting scaling. I'm concerned about the Dazed 2 on Eaton. But maybe we can figure that out as we go along. And now here's Nightmare. Here's the one that shocked me a while ago. So, this is kind of like a Fade-style champion. In that it gains... It scales permanently based on Slay. Resolve, kill all pony units. So this unit's not a pony, it's a champion, so it doesn't kill itself. But apparently, Nightmare Tantibus wants to be on its own. Yeah, unit abilities only affect their current floor. So they only kill the pony units on the current floor. I see this might be difficult to play, given that... Now I really want to play this with the Hive Mind Mutator, so Nightmare just kills everything on the floor every turn. But no, it's... Anywho, I digress. Let me focus and let me figure out. Nightmare is definitely interesting, but I think I'm going to go with Lucid for now. Okay, the Horde. 0 cost for the first spell card played each turn. Well, that definitely makes the Night Terrors a lot more playable. And then Unbroken Horn. Pretty much always good. But I do believe I would like to try out the Royal Scroll. Question is, do I take this Horde or not? Let's look at the map. Okay, got my first temple on 2. Hellhorn banners and no equestrian banners until 4. Going steel, have a 4 steel shop on 2. And an optional magic shop on 3. Then probably hitting up the Equestrian Banner Steel Shop and Vortex on 4. We have a Horde on 3, so we could be going high shards really quick if we're not careful. I think this time I'm gonna go ahead and not take the Horde. I want to exercise caution as I learn this champion. I definitely want a unit draft. I apologize for my voice. I had an 11-hour D&D game yesterday, and when you speak with in a baritone Belfast accent for that long, it definitely wears on the vocal cords. And I would definitely like to just go ahead and put... Well, I can't. Okay. I was about to say put meat wall down, but... That is not in the cards. And there's the poison joke. It's going to get eaten and daze him, and I'm fine with that. I would like the money here. And we're just going to play that out. Alright. I really do wish that my packed audiences would have shown up before Eaten Pile, before my poison joke. I also wish there was a way I could get rid of this dazed, but I'm not really seeing it. So anywho, you get Night Terrors. I don't know what, if anything, I'd do with this packed audience. I guess just load it up. Because I don't want to redraw them. I know that much. Okay, Molting Imp definitely happening. I guess I'll just do a little bit of damage here. We'll do a bit more damage again. I guess the Night Terror is the only card still left in my deck. It's kind of funny. But, I mean, when you're running Imp secondary, I guess that happens. Okay. So, Rush to Kill, not particularly great. Helps with survivability, but in general, not good for scaling. Bakery Warfare is pretty good. Reserves seems pretty good with the Royal Scroll, but we don't have background ponies, and we're not going to be doing the same tactics we did with Maria Lee. So for now, I believe that we're going to take a Pastry Warfare. I like Hornbreak, I like Hidden Passage. I'm kind of seeing something similar to the Fledgling Imp plan, where I have Poison Joke and I kill it off every turn. So to that end, I like Hornbreak. But Yeah, Night Terrors also gets the job done. I'm gonna take Hornbreak. Alright. We're not on a rage plan. I don't like any of these units. Do not like them. Regardless, I am only taking a two space unit. So I think, for purposes of having a unit, I'll grab one from the Hellhorn banner. I'm gonna skip here. I'm not feeling any of those. Peeking at my steel shop, hoping to see Endless. I see Quick. And I get pretty much the same guys, but I'll take the Horned Warrior. I like Horned Warrior a little bit more than I like Branded Warrior. Alright. I am gonna spin it because we are Covenant 1. 5, 105. Okay, I can get both of these. Seems good. Did not get Endless, but that's okay. Oh, I was hoping for some plus magic damage here. I'm not feeling spell chain. I kind of want, given that we're at zero shards, when's my next temple? 5. My next temple's at 5. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and make this infusion now. Molting Imp into Poison Joke. Excuse me. Not a great start, but I think we're going to be fine for this next ring at least. Spikes 3 with a Horned Warrior. No healing. I would like some money for the magic shop. Or I could potentially vent my my poison imp. Oh, Forged Disciples. This is a hard call. Spikes 3 is not nothing. No, I'm not going to risk it. It's unfortunate. Which means I really need to go hard after the collector. I kind of want to play bottom on this one. For primarily that reason right there. You die off, right? Good. You still die off if I hit you? Yeah. Very good. I've got to get rid of these packed audiences. They're doing nothing for me. Night Terrors, the collector. Get those out of my deck. Just get everything out of my deck. Alright. Well, this is actually pretty good here. Alright. Molting Imp. Night Terrors. But a Queen Zipling in front to absorb the first hit. And Reckon will just put you down and win. Seems good. Party invitation. Time to Shine is scaling. I don't necessarily know that I want that with Horned Warrior. But I like that better than I like Dress to Kill. So we'll take Time to Shine. Fledgling Imp. Ah, man. That would have been a good infusion for my poison joke here. But that is just not... was just not in the cards. I'm going to go ahead and take the Hidden Passage here. With 105 gold, there's no value to be found here. Branded Warrior is not the worst infusion for him, but I don't think he's the guy. So we're going to skip here. We're definitely going to take the Horde here. What a disappointment. Volatile Gauge is interesting. Because I have the plus one per turn, and I have the Royal Scroll. Yeah, I actually like Volatile Gauge here, strangely enough. Alright, what am I venting? I didn't find Endless for my poison joke. But I have a Steel Shop on 4. I could potentially vent the Horned Warrior and play two of them with space, but then I wouldn't have room for the poison joke. So I think for now, I'm going to go ahead and dupe the poison joke. Ah, that could have been better, but you know what? I'll take it. Dazed Talus, let's get it. Alright. The downside to the gauge in the Royal Scroll is not being able to see what things cost when you cast them. And get rid of a Train Steward. Scale my dudes. Eat. I don't want my champion dazed. We'll draw back into it. We're gonna get rid of all that sap. I'm starting to see survivability as an issue here. Night terrors you. Night terrors you. And put 155 into Talos. Start with a Night Terrors on Hasty Boy. Yep, and then you can kill him off, which is great. And I'm gonna play out another Train Steward, I think. Out of Night Terrors first, I think. Okay. Okay. That seems good. And then kill off Hasty Boy through a damage shield, which is good. And I'm going to absorb this hit here. Seems good. I'm going to consume these out. I don't want them in my deck right now. Let me go ahead and put you front for now. And we're good there. And I would love to put a whole bunch of days into you. It's 5 days. And you know what? Let's just go ahead and bring you up. Yeah, it's a lot of dead ponies. And just get the easy victory. Alright, Changeling Infiltration. I'm not feeling any of these. Or maybe... I don't know. Changeling Infiltration with Volatile Gauge could be good. Man. What is with my unit drafts today? Where are my ponies at? We're going to skip here. And I would like space. Right now I'm good on Ember and I'm good on Draw. Alright. I'm going to pause real quick so I can clear up my throat and be right back. Alright, and we are back. First, I want to take a look at my champion since I'm not familiar with them. Alright, so same deal, more stats and more Ember. Sounds good. Alright, oh, Guardian of the Gates. Hello again. Hello again. I don't have rejuvenation triggers. How am I gonna do this? I guess we're running without an infusion for Horned Warrior. And we can play Guardian on pretty much any floor that doesn't have Tanibus and Horned Warrior on it. Yeah, I think we pick up Guardian. Merchant of Steel. What do we got? Large Stone. Can't do anything with any of this. There's Endless. Okay, so we now have a scaling. We now have an Endless Poison Imp. And I would kind of like to get a little more beef in the Guardian of the Gates. Eventually, I would like to see Quick. But I'm not sure that our run's going to support that. Let's see. I want these packed audiences out of my deck. I want a lot of things out of my deck. We're going to start with these train stewards because space on the train just became a premium. I think I want to pick up more cash. Yeah, I'm going to be heading to the magic shop next. So definitely. Multi-strike with haste conduits. Nope, not today. I don't know yet what I'm doing with this deck. I know what I'm doing right here, though. Guardian of the Gates. Changeling Infiltration. That's happening. Then I'll put Tanibus up here for the Ember. And we'll have to redraw a Horned Warrior, but that is absolutely fine. With that start that we just hit, absolutely fine. I would like to lose a packed audience. Now we're going to go ahead and play out the poison joke. Do that. Okay, playing out the Horned Warrior now. Definitely getting rid of this. Gonna Horn Break you to save 10 damage. Yeah, I think we're good here. Alright. Poison joke. Night terrors. Bring you forward since you have more health. Night terrors. Pastry Warfare. And I would like to play out the Molting Imp. We're good here. Yep. Poison Joke. Night Terrors. And we can't really play anything else in our hand. Yeah, that's some pretty impressive scaling, all things considered. I mean, we already have the victory downstairs, but I mostly just kind of want to see what our current power level is. This is not going to last long in Divinity. And this was kind of a freak once in a however often occurrence. I'm gonna grab Blank Flank here. Inferno with a Volatile Gauge is always great, but not today. We're gonna skip here. Alrighty. Peek in the temple. Still no magic power. Minus two. Now, show me a remove consume. No, double stack. What exactly are you double stacking on Changeling Infiltration? That's pretty good. But for right now, I need magic power in my Night Terrors to make them still functional. I'm gonna spin it here. Minus one is still valuable. I wouldn't mind a minus one into you. Remove consume. Okay then. 10 magic power into a Night Terrors. Minus one into. I actually kind of want to put a minus one into Pastry Warfare. And now we're going to come here and we're going to minus two this Changeling Infiltration. And this is going to be great. I'm actually going to buy a purge for here. And we're going up to 90 shards, but I feel really good about being at 90 shards right here. We still need an answer for Seraph the Patient. We haven't really found one yet. Well, we're at Covenant 1, so this kind of loses its value somewhat. Both, then this one loses its value because we have Volatile Gauge, so we're taking nothing from this cavern event, which is unfortunate, but you know, it is what it is. I took everything I wanted here, just double checking. Yeah. Crystal Cloak, eh? I can handle a plus six, and I am broke. I need the cash. Okay. Very good. Okay. I like it. So we're going to put you down here. Or are we? Yeah, we're gonna put you down here. We're gonna put y'all up top. And we're gonna do Night Terrors on you. Play out the packed audience mid. That seems good. Neat. plan that out. And gonna kill it off. Not a great hand this time around. We'll bring you up. Play out Pastry Warfare. And we'll call it for now. Okay. And start with Poison Joke and Night Terrors. Alright. Interesting. Volatile Gauge. Is Volatile Gauge not working with my pony cards? No, it has to be. Yeah, it has to be. I don't understand how this could cost two. With Volatile Gauge's mechanics, it starts with four, and then ignores that, sets that from one to three, and then subtracts two. So I'm not sure what's going on here. Nonetheless, Time to Shine is, it doesn't matter which one I use. Yeah, well, Night Terror's here. I'd like to purge my packed audience. And I can't really do anything else. Alright. Let me check up top, make sure we're still good here. We're not. We're going to take 21 to the pyre unless I can figure something out. Oh, no, we're not. We got this. And then you get killed off. That makes me happy. I'm going to get you out of my draw. Rolling Imp just keeps getting hit by three. Alright. And then Night Terrors. I really wish I'd have drawn this next turn. Dang, I drew both my Blink Flink and my Trap Shoot. So yeah, Crystal Cloak's gonna tear up my dogs. Unfortunate. That kind of makes me want to move one of my dogs up. I'm going to do that. And then there's really nothing else I can play out here. Okay. I'm going to do Changeling Infiltration up here. Oh! Well, dag. So much for that plan. Alright. Infiltrate you. That's why you read the cards. Oh, and now I can't play this out. Well, I just screwed this up every which way, didn't I? Well, I can still kill you and you. Yeah, I can't really do anything. I'm full in every sense of the word. Alright, how about now? Okay, now we're good. There's pastry warfare. We have that going for us, at least. Alright. We'll just, call this a very weird victory. Okay. I'm starting to see how the cards that I've picked interact. And I think we're going to have a better go of it starting from here. Herd 5 is not happening, not in this deck. Interrogation, I have zero ponies. Okay, great. And I'm not really feeling winner wrap up, so we're going to skip all that. Tiresome Climb. Good for Seraph. Yeah, we'll take that. Is there something particular I want in the magic shop other than spell damage? There really isn't. So I'm gonna go where the removals are and get rid of these train stewards. I'm going to peek in the trinket shop. I'm going to re-roll and hope for Split Anvil. No. In fact, Scorched Steel hurts me. I'm going to buy a couple purges. And those purges are going to be Queen's Implings. I think I only want to buy two for now. Well, that's a removal dupe with cash. No, you know what? I'll go all out. Let's buy, well, not all out, but let's get one more purge. Let's get these Queen's Implings out of my deck. They have no business here. Finally get me some magic power. Okay. What am I doing? So I got removal dupe on 7, and then I have removal dupe on 8 with a steel shop. So I'm not going to see another magic shop. So it's now or never for magic power. I think the Hornbreak is more valuable than the Night Terrors. And I'm actually going to go up on shards a little bit. Because I want my deck thin. And I really want this packed audience gone. Alright, 115 shards. Oh, nope. Got a Caverns event to do real quick. Yeah, might as well. Doesn't hurt. Very underwhelming Caverns this run. But what are you gonna do? Don't care what's going on middle. Another pretty good start, all things considered. Gonna drop you bottom, as per usual. And I do believe I would like to go ahead and purge this thing. Interesting, the rally triggers didn't happen. That's good to know. Okay. Fairly good start, all things considered. Okay. We begin with Changeling Infiltration. We'll do Night Terrors. Might as well daze you guys. One of you still hitting me. Which one? Oh, all three of them went on the Quill Marksman. Well, ain't that something? That sure is. And I kind of want to get rid of this other one here. Okay. Next. What are you? Your rally? That's fine. We're going to begin with Blank Flank to remove the Heartless. Now, we're going to Changeling Infiltrate him to make a third puppy. Continue our scaling upstairs. Five waves remaining, now's not the time. Not yet. Yeah, you're the rally shard. I wouldn't mind getting rid of your spell shields, honestly. I might as well go ahead and pump a little bit of daze into you. Incant. Okay, good to know. I guess I'm going to let my poison joke go for now. Incant. Ugh. I actually do not know how Incant works with Volatile Gauge. I think it affects it for this turn, and then for subsequent turns it doesn't. So that's good to keep in mind. I think I am going to go ahead and hold over my scaling dude here. Let's bring you forward since you have a bit more HP. Yeah, I'm going to pastry warfare you. Get you some days. Excuse me. Here we go again. I'm going to blank flank you. Changeling Infiltration for a fourth puppy. And Night Terrors. Bring you up for some more days. And I honestly want this Molten Imp out of my draw. So, let's do that. Incant. Good to know. Continue our scaling. Night Terrors. Pastry Warfare. Okay. Love that dazed. Seems good. And yes, I was correct about the interaction between Volatile Gauge and Blinding Dark Shard. Or not Blinding Dark Shard, the other shard. The Incant Shard. I'm not sure if that was the right call. Probably wasn't. And nonetheless, you weren't dazed. I guess the herb counts as a morsel? I don't know, I'll look into that in a minute. That's good to know. In the meantime, I definitely want a blank flank for you. Get you a tiresome climb. And I suppose that's it, except for just a quick 70 damage here. Nonetheless, you die on bottom. Oh yeah, changeling infiltration, yet another puppy. Pastry warfare for more days, and I'm not even going to bother playing the rest of it out. There's no point. Our puppies are breeding. Ooh. Dang. I cannot pull off herd 7. I can't. And I have the gauge to actually buy it, but I had quick and trampled with target friendly unit healed. Oh man. Now I'm starting to regret. Oh man. That's unfortunate. I don't want another changeling infiltration, though. Merch Desire. Eaten. Ember Drain 3. -2 for all cards played on this floor. Interesting. Herb, yeah, this unit does not truly trigger rally effects. Good to know. Alright. Alicornification. I would love to pull this off, but I don't think I can. Not anymore. Yeah. Dang. Maybe another time, Alicornification. So, two mines. I'm at the point now where I don't think I'm going to be needing space anymore. So I would like to have more Ember, specifically for turn one. And yeah, we definitely hit the removal dupe. Let me look at my champion here. Yeah, just more stuff and +3 Ember per turn. Nothing to write home about. Okay, what isn't performing? Molting Imp, easy. Now, you're on the block. And you're on the block. I don't know though. Hidden Passage lets me move my guardians, the gates, around. And that's pretty cool. Time to Shine is not providing any meaningful scaling. Yeah, I think it's time to shine. Or it could be this Night Terror, honestly. I don't know, this Night Terror still kills off. My poison imp. It's time to shine. Time to shine does less than my unupgraded Night Terror. So, dupe could be a couple things here. Could be changing infiltration, could be blank flank. I honestly think for right now, we're going to dupe the blank flank and possibly dupe the changing infiltration next ring. And I'm gonna go ahead and take the shard because I would like the cash. Spell Shield 2. How much do I care about that? I don't think I do. Yeah, I really don't. I will take your money. Oh, okay. I suddenly care a little bit. I didn't even look. These are pyre wings. We'll be okay, though. We're gonna be just fine. Oh yeah, this is also on the chopping block. Now that I'm no longer heavily reliant upon my top floor scaling, I no longer need this. We're gonna do you and you. And I guess we chill here. Okay, well. We're gonna start with the changing infiltration. Blank flank to remove the heartless on both. Excuse me. I'm gonna pastry warfare you so that you don't ember drain me up here. Gonna horn break you, and I think we're good. How do I want to do this? I do want to scale up here. Nothing I can do about that. I guess I could blow a trap shoot here. That might actually be worthwhile. Yeah, I actually think it is. Cool. Okay. Let's move on. Continue scaling. What did I just kill? I thought that was the. Oh, I killed the non-endless one. Okay, that's fine. That is fine. Anywho, I'm gonna blank flank you. I'm gonna save some damage, I think, is the correct way to go. Yeah. Nothing else to play there. Sorry, I had to think about that for a sec. Alright, we begin with Changeling Infiltration. And Night Terrors. Seems good. And I'm gonna blank flank you. Yeah, I can easily do 210 damage up here, so I'm gonna stop the Ember Drain from happening. Changeling Infiltration. There's some Night Terrors. Let's see, blank flank, blank flank. And I think we're good. Alright, yeah, we should have the easy victory downstairs, so I'm just gonna let it happen. Okay, Spontaneous Song and Dance. Herd 4 is far more achievable than Herd 7. I like Spa Treatment too, but I don't think it's any of these. I think we are simply brute forcing this run. I will honestly take another Tiresome Climb though. Once again, that's a Seraph plan. Removals. You're not endless. You get removed. And I think we're kind of at the point now where this hidden passage has... I can't remember the last time I actually cast it. So let's get rid of it. Show me quick. Show me quick. Dang. Oh well. Large stone. Did I just screw up my run? I just did. I can't fit it on the floor now. I am an idiot. Or am I? It's still showing 6. I guess 6 is the maximum size? Is that true? 6 the maximum unit size? I mean, I guess we'll find out. I guess we will find out. Anywho, here's Changeling Infiltration. I don't want Spell Chain with Volatile Gauge. I would like to go up to 150 shards, but I don't think we have anything that makes sense to do that with. I can't take any of this. If I were to grab the Pyre Stone housing, not much. But I got a bunch of money I can't spend. That being said, that's a summon ability. So yeah, that's happening. Yeah, and I have a bunch of money I can't do anything with. I've done all the purges I want to do. So yeah, let's just buy everything and call it a day. Get you some more HP. Are we sure we don't want to purge anything? Two blank flank, two changeling infiltration. If it's anything, it's this night terrors, and that still is working for me, so... No, we will go fight Seraph the Patient. I'm feeling pretty good about this. Assuming that I didn't just make my entire run not playable. Where is... Oh, wow. I did not draw my... That's the first time that's happened. Alright, so these guys are going by. That's fine. I would like to go ahead and get the days started. Get 4 days on you. Alrighty. Yeah, no, we didn't irrevocably screw up our run. Alright, I don't want to cast that blank flank here. And night terrors. More days for you. More days for you. I guess I'll go ahead and kill you off. Doesn't hurt. Okay. Let's talk. I'm going to go ahead and cast this blank flank, because I want to see my cost for everything. Okay, this is free. That's easy. Three. And then Night Terrors. And yeah, I can just pump Dazed into you all day. Alright, we'll start with a blank flank. I can unfortunately only do it once, but that's fine. Keep you scaling up top. I got one more days in the Seraph, prevented some damage, so that ain't bad. And might as well go ahead and just put 75 more damage into Seraph. That seems pretty nifty. No, blank flank is the most important thing right now. Yep, yeah, we're fine. Changeling infiltration. Poison imp. Tiresome Climb both came in at 3, but that's okay. 15 days into Seraph. I think we're going to be okay. We're going to be just fine. Blank Flank. Very good. Changeling Infiltration. Oh, look at that. You can get 3 more days. And a flying kill. Without even using our dog. Well, barely using our dogs for it. Okay, this was a run. I'll say that. This was a run. Not how I was expecting it to go. Okay, well. Puppy. Changeling infiltration. Blank flank. Changeling infiltration. And we'll play out Tanibus. We'll redraw into our Horned Warrior at some point, I think. Cool. All right, Daze you. Matter of fact, I don't want to worry about you for a little bit. I would like to prevent 20 damage here. Seems good. All right, making more puppies. And then Night Terror. And we'll blank flank in the back. Disposable puppies. That's seems so wrong. My God, look at this floor. And we have room for two more puppies too. That's the crazy thing. All right. Blank flank is the most important card to play here. Okay, this is doable. Night Terrors. Tiresome Climb, Pastry Warfare. All right, I don't have to worry about dazing you anymore up here. I can just now focus on the bottom. Okay, looks good. I'm gonna copy you. We're gonna copy you. And because we're gonna lose our front puppy, let's make you not heartless anymore. This is our crappy Night Terrors, unfortunately. Go ahead and blank flank a second puppy. Night Terrors. Let me get rid of this trap. Oh, wait, never mind. We win. Huh. I hadn't even realized we won. I was so focused on making puppies that I forgot to win the game. Well, thank you for joining me for this run. I had a great time. Hope you had a good time. And I will see you next time. Though I'm going to do a quick after battle report here. So, this was a weird case that just sometimes happens with Monster Train where you have a totally viable line planned out. We had our Tanibus that removed sap so that we could eat our herbs. Where are you? Well, eat our poison joke. Our poison imp here. And it would totally have worked out. We would have needed a little bit more. We'd have definitely needed an infusion, maybe more space and dupe him. But this was working out. But then we saw something else that was just working better. Just play Puppy Siege here and just keep copying him over and over and over. And that's Monster Train for you sometimes. Well, thank you again for joining me. Good night, YouTube.